Yes, I'm streaming before I'm playing the game. How sweet it is. It'll have some advertisements over there. Oh shit, my thing went crooked. Looks pretty good. Well, the discovery that I'm talking about is I only got one channel in my earbuds. I swapped mixers, I swapped adapters. I mean, it's really a strange problem I got with my mixer setup. So this timelines thing that I'm talking about regarding the radio tower, as some might know, the radio tower is an entry portal to the DLC. And that seems to be loud. So the DLC was something that they added to this game, and it's kind of a separate storyline. And as I said, mentioned in probably one of my other previous streams, that you can. You could yawn while you're playing the game. So, when you play this game, there's what's called, in order to save the game, it only saves at the beginning of what is called resets. And so, if you're halfway through a 20-minute session before the supernova explodes, the supernova explodes like every 20 minutes or something, then you will lose all your progress. Because what happens is it resets that particular timeline. Which was not the intent of the quote unquote timelines that I put in the stream, but. And you won't remember what you did in that scenario. You only remember what you did once you complete the time. Now, it seems kind of redundant that the supernova explodes every 20 minutes and you're out there gathering information. That's the way they got it set up as far as. Like, so there might be a situation where you've got to solve certain things, and I still haven't figured this out yet. If I go to Attle-Rock, which is the moon, and I set a device in motion, and then I go back, is that device still in motion? When the supernova explodes, is it still in motion? So, with that, if that's, I'm thinking it's not the case. So, if you do something that requires a mechanical change to something, and the time the supernova explodes, you have to go back and redo that. So if that change in the physical environment needs to occur prior to something else, which might be 10 or 15 minutes down the road, all of a sudden you don't have a lot of time to complete whatever mission it is that you're doing. That's kind of a situation. And I only seem to have one earbud working. So maybe what I'll do, for example, is I'll go to Adalark, spin that thing around, and shit. What I should also do is grab my clock. I've got a clock that I can monitor. On my other computer. I want this clock up here. Oh god, is it froze? Oh my god. I almost thought my other computer froze on me for some stupid reason. So I'm gonna try to watch my clock and see, like, when this, how long the reset time actually is, so that I can plan to go back to Adalrock and, well, yeah, I'm just thinking when the time resets that you've got to do that again. Now, every time the time resets, there's what's called there's a digital probe cannon. There's a probe cannon around one of the planets, and it sent out the probe somewhere into space, and I couldn't seem to follow it. And every time the time resets, it sends this probe out, and that probe cannon explodes. And there's a question about some of the modules on the probe cannon. My thinking is that I'm going to just look for the musicians, make sure that I know how to get access to the musicians. Once I do all that, go back and talk to, I should probably go back and talk to one of the people at the observatory each time I talk to one of those musicians. So, for instance, we're there now, so we could talk to Gavro. I don't think Esker was a musician. So I'm not really sure what my goals are on this particular stream, but fixing the mouse might be one of them. Yeah, let's see, we're over here. It's a nice little game. It's got some puzzles. So there's that probe cannon exploding, and there goes that probe. Now, actually, what I was thinking was that when I got up there quick enough, I thought I saw it land on Hearth, which is this planet here. And it may have been the star seed. But that doesn't... Did they launch a star seed out of that cannon? Or did some other civilization do that, you know? Yeah, I know. I gotta use that camera. Let's go to the observatory. Oh, I can't get up that way. So there's no shift one. What she talks about. That model rocket. I want to go to the observatory. Wait, am I streaming again? Okay, talked to Gabbro, and I got no information regarding that satellite from him. And he's the one that was supposed to fix the problem up there. That sun's quite yellow right now. Wait, observatories over here. Let's see what these folks have to say. I was just walking. Actually, I haven't read that message. I gotta read that message on there. See that fella, Hornfels is his name. He usually walks up here. He's got his radio and stuff. That's his messages, his notes. That's a map of a real-time map. So two planets have moons. That's Herthian. Addle Rock is a moon that goes around Herthian. And now this thing here is a satellite right there. Which I can't get a bead on because it's not in the plane of. So when that gets to the top, it doesn't show up here. They said 47 degrees. Well, that would be 90. Maybe 45 degrees would be here. But the entryway into this quote-unquote DLC is what's called an invisible, like, black hole type thing. It doesn't show up here. But anyway, Giant's Deep's got a moon. Maybe it doesn't let me click on the items in this particular map. Let's go back down and talk to this Hornfels fella and see if anything transpires. This is the walking crystal. Thank you. the satellite. This must be, maybe this new exhibit and the radio tower, the satellite, maybe all of, they said the radio tower was actually there before the DLC, but you couldn't interact or do anything with it. Now you can go inside the radio tower and interact with certain things. This is on Adelrock. It's the Mai ruins, and those glyphs with that thing in the middle is a portal. And I don't know if it's both an entry and an exit portal, but it's definitely an exit portal. I haven't been here. We haven't explored all of Adelrock, but we did find that the harmonica player is in the little seed thing, and we sent a probe through that seed, and it found it. That's talking about the crystal on Little Hollow. Let's go back out. These are. I need to read this. Snow and ice hit inside of my house. Now my writing was essential to deciphering a unique language. At the beginning, this statue turned around, and that was the beginning of the resets and the save points in the game. So that took care of that problem. So I was always wondering about how does the game save itself? So every time you have 20 minutes, the supernova explodes, and then you relive that, your memories are saved, and you get to continue on your research. But that also is a save point. Okay, so we've got to tell Gabbro about this. They said the eyes are open, so they must have been closed before. That means, like, this statue. Supposedly it's representative of the Namai people. But we don't 100% know that yet. Tempera's first and only space program, Feldspar, went there to Adelrock, which is where we gotta go. There's still a lot to explore on this moon. I wanna go back. Gabbro's been identified, so we can identify him. Abracadabra was hard to find. I forget. This game looks pretty good. Let's update this map. So, let's go find Gabbro. But before we do that, now the moon's hard to land on because of low gravity, so you gotta let it kind of settle in and don't move the mouse. If you move the mouse, it moves the ship. Let the suit phase in and everything here. So we know these things represent various bodies in this system. What we don't know... Now, this... Oh, I got a message. Shit. Bear with me for a minute here. While I respond... Gonna take a little break here and maybe be back in a bit.